Hello children, I am Prasanna. In this video, I am going to explain 5.3 exercise of unit 5 triangle and its properties of 7th class. So in my last video, I have explained 5.3 exercise 1 to 5 sums. Now in this video, we will do from 6th sum onwards. So coming to 6th question, the angles of a triangle are in the ratio 1:2:3. Find the angles. And what is angle sum property children? Sum of the angles in a triangle is 180 degrees. So here they have given the ratio of three angles, that is 1:2:3. We need to find the angles here. So what is given ratio? Given ratio is nothing but 1:2:3. Now here we need to find the sum of the terms of a ratio. That is 1 + 2 + 3. We should add. So 1 + 2 is 3 + 3 is 6. So you got the sum of the terms of a ratio as 6. Now sum of the angles in a triangle is how much? (180 degrees). So here we need to find now, therefore, first angle. How to find first angle? What is the first ratio here? 1. 1 by total parts is 6 into sum of the angles in a triangle is 180. So when you cancel, 6 ones are 6, 3 is 18, 0. So 1 into 30 gives you 30 degrees. Coming to second angle. 2 by 6, second ratio is 2. 2 by 6 into 180. 6 × 30 2 × 30 60 degrees. Coming to third angle, what is the third ratio? 3. 3 by 6 × 180 degrees. Three into 30 degrees is nothing but 90. So first angle is 30 degrees, second angle is 60 degrees, third angle is 90 degrees. So you can check 30 plus 60 plus 90. So you will get 180. So finally sum of the angles in a triangle is 180 degrees. Coming to 7th sum children. In the figure, DE is parallel to BC. See the figure. Here DE is parallel to BC and angle A is 30 degrees, angle B is 50. Find the value of X, Y and Z. So it's very easy children. First see this triangle ABC. In triangle ABC, angle A is given as 30, angle B is given as 50, angle C we don't know. First we'll find out angle C, that is Z value, by using angle sum property. So here in triangle ABC, angle A plus angle B plus angle C equal to 180. So it is what? Angle sum property. So what is angle A here? 30 degrees. What is B here? 50. And what is C? Z equal to 180. So 30 plus 50 is 80 degrees plus Z equal to 180. So what is Z here? 180. Take this plus 80 to the other side, minus 80. So Z equal to 100. So you got the value of Z here. How much we got children here? Z as 100. Okay. Now we need to find the value of X and Y. Now here they have clearly given that the BC is parallel to DE. Here this is BC. This is DE, and take this one as a transversal children, and here is X and here is Z. So here already they have given the two lines are parallel. When the two lines are parallel, you know that corresponding angles are equal, alternate interior angles are equal, alternate exterior angles are equal, and sum of the interior angles on the same side of a transversal is supplementary, right? Now if you see that figure, what is this X and Z forms children? They form corresponding angles. What are corresponding angles? the angle one should be in the interior and one should be on the exterior and on the same side of a transversal, and they are not adjacent. Now here x and z form corresponding angles. Therefore, x is equal to z. These are nothing but corresponding angles. So corresponding angles are equal when the lines are parallel. Therefore, x is equal to 100. Yes or no, children? Since z is 100. Yes. Now we got the x value. This has 100 degrees. Now coming to y. Y is also same like children here. If you see, this is BC and this is DE. Okay. Now this is a transversal. And here is the y and here is the 50. So what are the y and 50 forms? Same. Corresponding angles. Right. So what should I write here? Y equal to 50 degrees. Because they form corresponding angles. So here y you got 50 degrees. So therefore x value is 100, y value is 50, z equal to 100 degrees. Next, 8th question, children. In the figure, angle ABD equal to 3 into angle DAB. So what is ABD here? This is nothing but 3 into DAB, and angle BDC they have given 96 degrees. Find ABD. So they are asking you to find this one. So if you see this, if you consider this triangle ABD, here this is an exterior angle and these two interior opposite angles. Here can I use the exterior angle property, children? You know exterior angle is equal to sum of the two interior opposite angles, right? So here I take angle ABD plus angle DAB equal to angle BDC. Is it correct? Here what is BDC? BDC is the exterior angle. Exterior angle is equal to sum of the two interior opposite angles. So what is this? This property is called exterior angle property. Right. Now here if you see, angle ABD is given in the question 3 into DAB. So in place of ABD I will write 3 into DAB plus and DAB as it is equal to what is BDC given here? 96 degrees. Now 3 DAB plus DAB gives you 4 into angle DAB equal to 96 degrees. Now what is DAB here? DAB is nothing but 96 degrees by 4. So when you cut with 4, for 2s are, for 4s are. So you are getting angle DAB as 24 degrees. Okay. But what is ABD is given? Given angle ABD is nothing but 3 into angle DAB. So 3 into what is DAB here? 24 degrees. So 3 into 24 will give you how much? 72 degrees. Therefore angle ABD equal to 72 degrees. Next, coming to 9th question. In triangle PQR, angle P is given as 2 into angle Q. Angle P is given as 2 into angle Q. And 2 into angle R is nothing but 3 into angle Q. So calculate the angles of PQR. So we need to find here angle P, angle Q and angle R. P is given as 2 into angle Q. 2 into R is given as 3 into angle Q. So take let angle Q equal to X, children. So here then what is angle P becomes? 2 into X. That is 2X. Then what about this one? 2 into angle R is equal to 3 into angle Q is X. So what is angle R here? 3X by 2. Now we got angle P as 2X, angle Q as X and angle R as 3X by 2. Now use angle sum property. In triangle PQR, angle sum property angle P plus angle Q plus angle R equal to 180 degrees. So here angle sum property, right? So what is P here? 2x. What is Q? X. What is R? 3x by 2 equal to 180 degrees. Now 2x plus x is how much, children? 3x. So 3x plus 3x by 2 equal to 180 degrees. Take LCM here. 2, 1, 2 times 2, 3 is a 6x plus 3x equal to 180. So 6x plus 3x is 9x. 9x by 2 equal to 180 degrees. 9x is equal to 180 into 2. When division transpose to other side, it will become multiplication. Then what is x here? 180 into 2 by 9. So when you do cancellation here, x is equal to 20 into 2. That is x equal to 40 degrees you got. Right? Now therefore, what is angle P now? Angle P here is 2x. So 2 into 40. How much? 80. What is angle Q? Angle Q we have taken as x. So it is 40. Then what is angle R? Angle R we got 3x by 2. That is 3 into x is 40 by 2. When we cancel, 3 into 20, that is 60. So angle P is 80, angle Q is 40 degrees and angle R is 60 degrees. Next 10th question, children. If the angles of a triangle are in the ratio 1 is to 4 is to 5, find the angles. So this type of sums are very easy, children. You know already this type of problem we have done in the same exercise 6th sum. Okay. So what is the given ratio here? Given ratio is nothing but 1 is to 4 is to 5. Now here you should find the sum of the terms of a ratio. Means 1 plus 4 plus 5. How much you will get? 10. Now you know sum of the angles in a triangle, that is interior angle sum property. Sum of the angles in a triangle is 180 degrees. Right? So what is the first angle now? First angle is, what is the first ratio? 1. 1 by total you got 10 into 180 degrees. So 0, 0 gets cancelled. So first angle is 18 degrees. Coming to second angle. Second angle is 4 by 10 into 180 degrees. Yes, 0, 0 gets cancelled. 4 into 18 gives you 72 degrees. Now coming to last third angle. Third ratio is 5. 5 by 10 into 180 degrees. 0, 0 gets cancelled. So 5 into 18, that is 90 degrees. You can check, children, if you want. If you add the three angles, 18 plus 72 plus 90, you will get 180 degrees. Coming to 11th question, children. The acute angles of a right triangle are in the ratio 2 is to 3. So find the angles of a triangle. You know right angle triangle. What is mean by right angle triangle? A triangle in which one angle is 90 degrees. Okay. So what about the other two angles? The sum of these two angles is also 90. Right? Sum of the two acute angles in a right angle triangle is 90 degrees. So they are in the ratio 2 is to 3. Find the angles of a triangle. So what is given? First we write. Given the ratio of acute angles. What is given? 2 is to 3. Right? And we will find the sum of the terms of the ratio. That is 2 plus 3 equal to 5. And you know sum of acute angles is how much? 90 degrees. Right? Here we should take 90 there. Therefore, first acute angle. How to find first acute angle? What is the first ratio? 2 by 5 into 90. You should not do 180 because already one angle is 90. The sum of other two acute angles is 90. So when we cancel with 5 table, 18. So 2 into 18 is nothing but 36 degrees. Right? Now we'll find the second acute angle. So what is the second ratio? 3. 3 by 5 into 90. So 5 when it cancel. So 3 into 18. 18 3 is how much? 54. Right? So the other two acute angles are 36 degrees and 54 degrees. Therefore, angles of the triangle. One is 90 degrees, other is 36 degrees and next is 54. When you add this 90 plus 36 plus 54, you will get 180 degrees. Next 12th question, children. In the figure, triangle PQR is the right angle at R. See here, this is a triangle PQR, here right angle. You know what is meant by right angle, right? 90 degrees. Now, ML is parallel to RQ. These two lines are parallel and angle LMR is 130. This is given 130. They are asking you to find angle LPM. LPM is this one. So, take this as X. LPM. So, let angle LPM equal to X. Next PML. Where is PML? PML means this. Take this as Y. So angle PML equal to Y. And angle PRQ. PRQ means this one. So take this as Z. Take angle PRQ equal to Z. So we need to find here X, Y, Z in the figure, children. If you see here properly, this 2, Y and 130 will form what? Linear pair. And what is linear pair? Sum of the two adjacent angles on a straight line is 180 degrees. These are supplementary. So here I will take first one, Y plus 130 equal to 180. So this is what? Linear pair. Okay. So what is Y here? 180 minus 130, that is Y is equal to 50. So you got the Y value. So this is 50. Okay, children. Now if you observe carefully, here ML and RQ are the two parallel lines and this is MR, this line. This line is what? Transversal. And here it is Y. You got 50 and this is Z. What do you call these two lines? 50 and Z, corresponding angles. You can take like that. Or 130 and Z forms some of the interior angles on the same side of a transversal are supplementary. You can take in any way, children. So here Y, second part, angle Y equal to angle Z. So these are corresponding angles. So therefore, Z is also 50, since Y we got 50. Okay, children? Now you got Y value, Z value. Now we need to find the X here. Now here, you Z you got 50 and R is 50, Q is 90, then P we need to find here. So we can take angle sum property. Angle P plus angle Q plus angle R equal to 180 degrees. This is what? Angle sum property. So what is angle P here? Pro no X. Angle Q is given 90 and angle R is 50 equal to 180. So X plus 90 plus 50 is 140 equal to 180. So X is equal to 180 minus 140. X is nothing but 40 degrees. So finally we got angle LPM as 40 degrees, angle PML as 50 degrees and angle PRQ as 50 degrees. Now 13th sum, that this is the last sum in this exercise, children. In the figure A, B, C, D, E, find angle 1 plus angle 2 plus angle 3 plus angle 4 plus angle 5. here this is like theorem children. Here we divide this into three triangles. So if I draw a line here, one, and here, so finally you will get three triangles here, right? And if you see here, three angles here, one angle here, two angles and one angle. Here I will take this as A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I. Here I am taking this triangle A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I. Now individually I will take separate angles here children. First I will take this first triangle. In that, what is that? Angle A plus angle B plus angle C equal to 180 degrees. Let this equation be 1. Coming to this middle one, angle D plus angle E plus angle F equal to 180 degrees. This is angle 2. Next, in that last triangle, angle G plus angle H plus angle I equal to 180. This is the third one. Okay, children. Now add 1, 2 and 3 equations. Now what you will get? Angle A plus angle B plus angle C plus angle D plus angle E plus angle F plus angle G plus angle H plus angle I equal to 180 plus 180 plus 180. Okay, children. Now if you see here, now I am combined 1, D and G. That is A, B, G first I write. Angle A plus angle D plus angle G in one bracket plus angle B. Next angle B. Next angle C and angle F in one bracket. Next angle E in one bracket. Next angle F plus angle I in one bracket. Next angle H. Here we got all the 9 angles equal to 180 plus 180 plus 180 will give you 540 degrees. Now what is this children? Angle A, D and G. If you see the D, A, D plus G gives you angle 1 in the figure. Plus in B, what is that here? B, angle 2. Plus C and E together is what in the figure? Angle 3. Next F and I will is angle 4. Plus H is nothing but angle 5. Equal to 540 degrees. So finally we got that angle 1 plus angle 2 plus angle 3 plus angle 4 plus angle 5 is nothing but 540 degrees.